Welcome. Approaching God in prayer is grossly misunderstood and often very misrepresented. There's times that I remember growing up that I got the idea as a child that unless I was willing to continually keep on praying for something, I could never really expect for God to hear me unless I came to a certain level of perfection in my life. I couldn't really expect God to hear me, let alone speak to me. There were many misunderstandings, misrepresentations in my life in regards to prayer, but it did for a very long time affect the way I was praying or the way I expected God was hearing me. And so I want to bring this back to the Word. I want to read to you 1 John 5 verse 15. And if we know that he hears us, whatever we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we have asked of him. I also want to read to you Matthew 7, verse 7 and 8. Matthew 7, verse 7 and 8. Ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and it will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives. And he who seeks finds, and to him who knocks, it will be opened. Now, when we come to the place of prayer, when we start to pray, we want to pray as if Jesus speaks the truth. We don't want to pray as if something still needs to be finished that Jesus already said is finished. We don't want to pray as if one day we're going to be clean. We don't want to pray as if one day we are going to see God finally clearer and more evident in our life, and finally he will begin to respond. Maybe one day he will even speak to me. When we come to the place of prayer, we either come with a preconceived idea of prayer or we come to a place of biblical prayer, God's definition of prayer. And so it is very important that we always bring our prayer life back to the Word. I'm going to read to you again verse 15 of 1 John chapter 5. And if we know that he hears us, whatever we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we have asked of him. If we are coming to the place of prayer, behaving as if we are not sure whether God will hear us, we're not believing the word. If we are coming to the place of prayer, behaving that in a way and speaking in a way that puts us in a position where we say, you know, I'm petitioning with the Lord. In other words, I'm asking for something. It's a petition. I'm bringing this petition before the Lord, but really, who am I that I would come and bring this petition? How could I ever expect God to answer me? But the beginning of the verse says, if we know that he hears us. In other words, if we have believed the gospel and if we are standing on the gospel, we are no longer looking at ourselves and we are no longer believing in the preconceived idea of prayer where there's so much more needed than the cross of Jesus Christ. If we know that he hears us in whatever we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we've asked of him. In other words, we're going to pray a whole different way when we know, when I open my mouth, God is listening. When I open my mouth, my Lord is eager to hear me out and to begin to give direction. How many of you know that when God says no, he's answered your prayer? Sometimes we're looking for our will. It's very important that we don't pray our will. We don't ask of God for him to do our will. We come to him based upon the word. So either you are praying as if Jesus speaks the truth, or you are praying according to feelings, or you are praying according to preconceived ideas. Now, if you are praying according to feelings, then sometimes you're going to feel close to God and you're going to be bold in prayer, and sometimes you're going to feel like a failure because of what you did. Now you're not looking at the cross. Now you feel like a failure because of what you did, and now you're so timid in prayer, you're like, well, maybe next week when I've had a couple of good days, I can pray like that again. Now you're letting feelings guide your prayer life, not the word. And when you have preconceived ideas, it gets pretty complicated. Let me give you the definition of the word preconceived ideas. That is an idea formed before having the evidence of its truth or usefulness. So there are these preconceived ideas about prayer that if I get loud enough or long enough or deep enough or fasting long enough, then God will hear me. Now, none of these things in itself are wrong. It's not wrong to spend a long time in prayer. It's not, there's nothing wrong with fasting. There's nothing wrong with sometimes being quiet, sometimes praying in private, sometimes praying loud. There's nothing wrong with these things. But when we have a preconceived idea about prayer that if we, again, starting with me, not with Jesus, if we pray long enough, maybe then God will hear. If I bother him with this long enough, then maybe he would give me the request. If I get loud enough, if I get quiet enough, if I get humble enough, if I get deep enough, if I would only touch it in prayer with the right words and the right, if the Holy Spirit would only reveal how I exactly should pray, then it's going to happen. When we have preconceived ideas that are not based on the Word of God, now we are praying an unbiblical prayer life. And we end up sooner or later praying as if Jesus does not hear you. Unless you do this, that, or the other thing in prayer, now you're praying as if Jesus doesn't hear you. The question is, are you praying as if Jesus speaks the truth? Or are you praying as if your feelings speak the truth? Or are you praying as if people speak the truth? Let me give you these three. No prayer gets answered because you are genuine. One of the preconceived ideas about prayer. If you are only honest, genuine, if you are only praying with a pure motive, a pure heart, then God is going to answer your prayer. Not biblical, not true. You can be genuine and you can be genuinely wrong. Just because you were genuine, the Lord doesn't answer prayer. The Lord doesn't answer your prayer because you pray long enough. I'm just going to stick with this in prayer. I'm going to pray it through. I'm not going to give up. It's been 7 years. I'm still praying. I'm not saying that there will never be times where you stay for a long time in prayer. But when you are staying a long time in prayer because you believe that if you would only see it through, then God will answer. Now you're praying out of unbelief in the finished work of Christ. And you believe that you have something to bring to prayer that may pull God over the edge. No prayer gets answered because you hit the mark in prayer. This is a big one. I struggled with this one for a while. I was struggling incredibly deep with fear in my life. And I had this preconceived idea about prayer. I didn't even know it. I could have never put words to it until the Lord delivered me. But I believed one day I'm going to be deep in prayer. One day I'm going to be long in prayer. One day I'm going to hit the mark in prayer. And something is going to break. Something is going to happen. I'm going to be finally delivered. And we prayed. My wife and I, we prayed. We stayed in prayer. We believed. But our belief was not based upon anything biblical. It was a preconceived idea about prayer. Remember, a preconceived idea is this. It is an idea formed before having the evidence of this truth or evidence of its usefulness. It took a lot of time, and God was leading us to the answer of our prayer. He wasn't going to deliver us in the place of prayer. We had brought it to him in prayer. He heard us. Now he was asking us to follow him on a crazy journey. Too long of a story to bring to you tonight. Some of you know it. A crazy journey that took us from the Netherlands to Portland, Oregon, then to Maine. And it was in Maine, right at the border of Canada, that the Lord had led us into the answer of our prayer that we were expecting was going to happen in a small room while we were on our knees in the Netherlands. The Lord had heard our prayer and was now inviting us to a journey of obedience to the answer of our prayer. Prayer gets answered because God is faithful to His Word. Write it down, put it somewhere, get it into your system. This is why God answers prayer, because He always stays faithful to His Word. What does that mean? You need to know the Word of God before you get into prayer. You need to know His Word so that you can approach Him in prayer biblically, so that you can approach him in prayer according to God's definition of prayer, not yours, not your preconceived idea about prayer, so that you can look at the scriptures and begin to say, now I am responding to the God that wrote these scriptures. I'm approaching him according to what he has said, what he has promised, and what he claims he will do for every single person that has believed in Jesus. I'm believing it. Now I'm coming to him, not asking for something he already promised. I'm coming to him because he has promised it. Very big difference. Let me read to you again, verse 7 and 8 of Matthew chapter 7. Ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and it will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, and he who seeks finds, and to him who knocks it will be opened. You do not need to put in a request for something that God already promised. Requests are for very specific things. God gave us an incredible amount of promises that are supposed to be the foundation of our prayer life. Because God has promised it, that's why we come to prayer. We have good reason to come, because we have promises. We're not beggars in prayer. We're not asking for favors in prayer. We have already been given promises. And now, instead of coming for a request, now we come believing the word of God. And we come rejecting lies. What that means is, because we know the truth, we reject our feelings and say, God, today I come to you in prayer. Lord, you wouldn't believe it, what my feelings are trying to tell me. Let's cast that stuff aside, Lord God, because I know what you've said in your word. Lord, I'm coming to prayer to you today because I really need to align my thinking. God, would you know all the stuff that's going through my mind today? Thank God, I've already heard and known the truth that God has spoken and bought for me on the cross. Lord, I'm right here in the place of prayer because my mind is trying to pull some quick ones on me. It's trying to play some tricks. Lord, would you come with the Holy Spirit, because I'm ready to align myself with the truth. Lord, I'm not coming here to pray my way. I'm coming here to pray your way. Lord, lead me to the word. You see, God is not interested in your sacrifice, nor is he intimidated by it, nor is he impressed by it. God is not impressed by fasting. Trust me, there's people, I don't care what you do, there's going to be people that have fasted more, deeper, longer, different than you. And God is never impressed by fasting. You know why we fast? We fast because we are so easily distracted. We fast because we do not know how to get away and take some time to get alone with God, to focus on his word, and to, based upon his word, now come and approach him. Sometimes we need to take extra time because life is just too fast and too quick, and therefore we come, we fast from media, we fast from food. You can fast from anything that just happens to take a lot of time in your life, and you say, for the next little while, Lord God, this is your time. Teach me the word, Lord God, that I may know how to pray. God is not interested in your sacrifice. He's not interested in you showing that you have huge spiritual muscles and you're going to push it through in prayer. You're going to stay in prayer. You're not going to give up. God is not going to be impressed by your prayer life. But God is interested in faith. You need to get this. It don't matter what kind of work you do. It don't matter if it's works in prayer. It doesn't matter if it's works praying in tongues. It doesn't matter what kind of works it is. When you are doing it, God is not going to be impressed, because he was looking for someone perfect. And trust me, it ain't you. But he already gave us a perfect sacrifice. He gave us a perfect mediator. He gave us a perfect lamb. And because of that lamb, now we can know that when we pray, God hears us. And if we know that he hears us because we know the sacrifice was accepted, we know we were forgiven by the blood of the lamb, we know that we are well beloved even though we were not loved, God called us beloved. We know that he hears us, therefore we know that we have the request. Now we come to prayer with a whole different attitude. It's not my failure that defines my prayer life. It's not my feelings. It's not my preconceived ideas. It's the cross that defines my prayer life. God is interested in your faith. Faith in what? Faith in what He has said and who He claims to be to you. Where do you find that? You find that in the Word. Allow the Holy Spirit to bring you to the Word daily, because He is trying to teach you so that you know how to pray.